Alright, so it's the day we leave for Moab. It is Christmas Eve. So right now I am waiting for Jeff. So Jeff should be here any moment now. I told him I want to leave around 6 to 7. And he liked the 7 o'clock a little bit better. But yeah, so we got a nice long journey ahead. We're going to be going the 25-hour drive out to Moab. Sadly, I have to leave Ashley behind because she couldn't get it off work. And Mr. Brutus, he's back there, leaving him. And little baby Willie. So I have to leave all those guys, but it's going to be a fun trip. Oh, he finally showed up. All right, so Jeff finally showed up.
Late. It's
a little bit late. I said between 6 and 7. He decided to do the 7 o'clock one. So we are about to hit the road. Got to say bye to the pups and bye to Ashley. She's over there. Bye, Ashley.
Bye. Bye, Ashley.
So it's first day in Moab. We are going to do Flat Iron Mesa today. We got in yesterday around like 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock after driving our 30 hours. So we got here. Here's the trailhead. So I'll show you guys this real fast. So that's it, we're ready to rock and roll. We got a stretch two door on coilovers and 40s and one tons. So we're in good company. So we're on Flat Iron Mesa again, and there's this cool little overlook we stopped at, and you can see the big mountains in the background and just some really, really cool scenery. That's what is awesome about Moab, is it's just scenery everywhere. Literally a couple minutes ago we jumped up a small herd of mule deer, and it's just always super cool to just to see those things. So we're just keep hanging out, keep rocking and rolling. All right, so we came up to, I believe the obstacle is called the CHUTE. It's just a big waterfall and it has a big steep edge, well, a big steep climb to get out of it. So I'm gonna give it a shot.
Shoot.
big climb. We're about to give it a shot.
Front locker.
My hub's not working.
Since the hub wasn't working, we tore it apart and put the gear in place so it would lock up. After that, we are good to go. Try hitting it a little bit to the right. Yeah. Yeah. Say I left a little bit of rubber behind. So this is absolutely beautiful, especially with the snow, but when you're on the trail you get to go right along this little canyon, and it's a big drop. It's absolutely gorgeous. Thank you. right, so we're gonna go on one of the main obstacles on the trail. It is Easter Egg Hill. So we are going to go down Easter Egg Hill. It starts up there and then we just make our way down a big rock. So these two rocks are the kind of problem. We're just gonna kind of hang into it and make a sharp right and come down. That's it to it. All right, so we reached the only part on the trail I was truly worried about. This is called the Intimidator. It is roughly 90 inches wide, give or take 90 inches. Our Jeep measures out to, you guessed it, 90 inches. So we're gonna see how this goes. It's gonna be a big time pucker factor moment. So you got this wall, so you have to rub your rock rings right on that wall and stay as close as you can. And then on the other side, we have complete instant death. Well, it might take a couple seconds for you to hit the ground. So it's not instant, it's a couple seconds death. Oh, he made that look easy, but he's 86 inches. Let's see what 4 more inches does. I did the Intimidator and I survived. Woo! All right, guys, that's it for this video. If you guys haven't entered to win, we're giving away a shirt, well, shirts and koozies and some stickers to two people. So if you haven't entered to win, you just gotta leave a comment on the one TJ video. So anyone that will be drawing that next week sometime for our next video. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, like, comment, share, all that good stuff, and hit that notification bell. Thanks, guys.